hello, welcome back. Okay, I've been messing about fuel tanks again, just to finalise this before I actually start chopping up my good tank, make sure everything's perfect. So I've decided to mount this, as I've already, as you know, as regular followers all know, I've had this fuel tank lined up in the outer skin, which will be the outer skin, two bolt holes at the front, and the RR4 tank has these little mounts at the side, threaded mounts, obviously mounts directly to the frame on the RR4. What I'm going to do, I've made up a little bracket, voila, which will mount on the inside of the outer frame and it's angled to pick up the mount on the inner tank one. So basically this inner and outer tank will be completely bolted together and can be, you know, just be used as a single tank basically. So I've made up one of the mounts. I'm going to go and see my welding man today about the plate on the back. And I think once I'm happy I've got the mounts right, I'm going to actually start cutting up my lovely tank and try not to break it. So that'll be a tense moment. But for now I'm just going to make another one of these side mountings. Okay, there we are. The fuel tank is fully mounted. Give it a good shake. Fully mounted on. That's the that's as good as I can get the cap across the top. Not bad. You know, it's not easy to try and get a petrol tank to line up inside another petrol tank, believe me. But that's as good as I can manage it anyway. So there's the inner brackets. One that side, one of course that side, and the two mounting at the front. So it's in there now. It's securely in there. So it's got to be my chappie later, get the piece welded on the back. And then I think I'm ready to tackle my real tank and cut that up. So that will be later in this video. Other news, remember my little cardboard reservoir for the radiator? Well, I decided I wouldn't wait for my alu man and I'd have a go myself using my holding bench, etc. And this is what we've come up with. It needs welding, obviously. I mean, it's not made to particularly tight tolerances, but of course it's going to be welded up, which will I hope make up for any deficiencies in my sheet metal work. There you go, there's the little sight gauge thing for the side. You can see what I was talking about there now, my ramblings on the last video. So basically you fill it up and the level sits somewhere between there, so I'm going to see how much fluid is within it. Only thing I need to buy is for the back is the little fitting to come out and bring off the feed to the radiator. I'm going to go for a nice red aero quick pipe coming out there. Look a bit of bling on the bike. But there we are. It's pretty happy with that. I mean, that's took me ages to make that, would you believe? It doesn't look like it. It's held together with gaffer tape just to keep it together. This top, it's a bit small, this top piece, I have to be honest. I think I'm hoping a bit too much that the world's going to be as wide as that, so I'm just going to have to remake that top one. But that's the only one which is suspect on it, really, the only panel of it. So yeah, they're pretty good. I mean, I think they'll look pretty smart in there, with the level and everything. So pleased with that one. Also, have to give a big shout out to Wicked Coatings, first of all, who are going to carbon coat these here pieces of plastic for me. These are the inner fairing pieces. I would have bought carbon ones of them, but you just can't buy them anymore. They're just not available for the 98 anymore. So they're going to carbon dip those. They're also going to carbon dip the headlight. That's the bit that sits inside the headlight, so that will be carbon look, and also the back of the headlight as well. So when that's on the bike and you're sitting on it, it'll look like a carbon fiber headlight on there, which would look quite smart. Also going to carbon dip the sprocket cover now. I was going to paint it, but I thought, hang on, let's get it carbon dipped just for that final touch. And also, I did finally get the correct rear triangles for the rear swinging arm. I'm going to get those carbon dipped as well, so that like carbon plates And that's it. So that lot is going off next week to Wicked Coatings in Poole. Can't say thanks to them enough. They've I'm just looking forward to see what the finish is going to be like when they come back. So I'll obviously show that when I have those returned to me. Also, I've sent my casings off, my alternator side. There's the engine all wrapped up because it's all the casings are off it now to keep the dust and filings out. But I've sent off the casings, both sides, and also the top yoke to Vapour Blast UK to get those aqua blasted. So Phil at Vapour Blast UK is going to tackle those for all your vapour blasting needs. He also does polishing. So all your polishing and vapour blasting needs go to Vapour Blast UK. He's based in Norwich, so I've posted stuff up to him. And so I should hopefully have those back next week as well. So we'll see how fancy those look. Time has come to take my delicious immaculate tank. There it is. And mutilate it, for want of a better word, into just an outer cover. So I've had it open this morning, been trying to get any petrol out of it, get all the fumes out of it, because I don't really fancy cutting into it and it exploding particularly. So I'm just airing it, and then I'm going to cut up some foam, and I pull some good masking tape, and I'm going to tape foam all around it. I'm probably going to mask the whole thing first, all around the edges, everything, and then mask on some foam on the outside so I can have it upside down without risking scratches, because the whole point is to try and avoid any damage on the outside of that tank. So yes, this is quite a tense moment because I don't want to be having to spend £300+ on a respray. So let's hope I don't balls it up. There we are. Masked, and I've just marked around roughly where I've got a cut. So what I've done, I've basically masked and taped the whole thing, and also taped on some foam to protect it, so I can push down on it, you know, without having to worry about damaging the paintwork. I'll do the inside, and I'll strip all that off around the filler cap, and I will cut out the filler cap as well from the top, which is going to be the tricky bit. So I'll probably have to remask again before I attempt that. But so here goes. Here we go. Well, talk about blooming tents, eh? Scary stuff that was. Tank is inside my decent tank. Look at that. It's in there. It was horrendous though. Despite my best valiant efforts, I couldn't but help due to the heat of the angle grinder. It's not, I mean, I'm making it sound really bad now. It's not at all. But there's a little burn mark just there, look. Little burn on there, which will bug the hell out of me. So I've got a plan, and that plan is to perhaps just to stop that, and obviously I could get the white repainted, but I really don't want to do that. So I'm thinking of just a little piece of maybe perhaps get someone to do it, but just have a little bit of carbon wrap just going around the top of there, a little, you know, very centimeter, let's say. You could even get the white carbon wrap, can't you? It looks like carbon white, just to go around there, just to hide that little burn on there. Because, yeah, I mean, it's just the heat from the angle grinder. The heat just burnt the paint. But apart from that, it's tickety-boo, really. Okay, masking tape off. God, it's bloody nerve-wracking, that was. I've not enjoyed doing this at all. I've enjoyed everything else during this bike, but doing this was just absolute nerve-wracking, to be honest. Even trying to just manoeuvre it. I've just drilled the holes, look. For the mounting on the inside. They look quite sweet, don't they? With the nice, that happy with that. The only, it's perfect. The only thing is that little burn. But never mind. But there we are. So that is the tank. I've just, all that I have still got to mount the brackets on the inside. But I'll do that later. But there we are. So So I need to put that away safely now. I will have to, the way I've, you know, the cuts on the inside are still raw, so I'll sand those down a bit. But the actual fit of the cap, with this, with the stock cap, is actually much better than the aftermarket one I had. So I'm really pleased with that, actually. That actually looks better than what it did on the mock-up tank, which is great. So, yeah, looking good there. Looking very, very nice indeed. There we are. Very nice indeed.